What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about installing PDQ inventory within your infrastructure. Super simple, so let's get right into it. All right, so installing PDQ inventory is super simple, and the first thing that we need to do is get the installation files. So once you get the installation files on your server, on your machine, or wherever you're installing this particular application, we need to right-click on the exe file. I'm going to run it as an administrator. You're going to get the user account control. We're going to hit yes here. It's going to load up the nice little wizard. We're going to click next here, accept the license and terms, then click next. By default, it is going to drop it inside the C drive. So I left everything as is and click on next here. Install. It's going to start copying all the new files, installing it. And once it's done, you're going to get this. By default, it is set to launch the PDQ inventory. So we are going to click on finish. This is going to load up for the first time. We are going to click next here. For the license key part, we have two options. You have free mode and you have enterprise. So pick your poison. And once you got that configured, click on next. Then we need to enter the domain, your username and password. Once you enter all that information, just click on next. And then it's going to start loading up the PDQ inventory. Now, once it loads up, it takes some time, but underneath the option that says tools, it eventually is going to pop up your domain. Took some time, but it will pop up. Now, nothing's in it, but to get stuff in it, we need to click on that little option on the toolbar that says add computers, and we are going to click on Active Directory Sync. You're going to get this here, and we are going to click on include container. From here, you're actually able to tell PDQ inventory which containers within your Active Directory you want to actually grab information from. Once you're done here, press OK. It takes you back here, and then you're going to click on sync now. You get a nice little warning. You must save your changes before syncing. Save now, click yes. It's gonna start syncing, and it tells you right there, last sync status is basically syncing, which is good. And give it some time. Eventually, the status is going to change to success. If you close this dialog box and then go inside your PDQ inventory console within your Active Directory node, if you kind of open that guy up, you will see all your OUs, which is a good thing. And all the OUs are going to be filled up with all your computer containers. It's going to start gathering information from all the computers within your Active Directory. Whether it's online, the last scan, the OS version, the last time it has a service pack release, the uptime, the current user. It grabs all this information, which is amazing. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Also, smash that subscribe button. And do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.